Hello and welcome to my presentation at USD 2021. My name is Sebastian Kort and I'm a research assistant at the Chair of Steel and Steel Composite Construction at the University of Siegen. My topic is the development of a transition piece for a self-erecting wind energy plant. Here you can see the structure of my presentation. I start with a short introduction to the research project itself. After that, I explain different tower concepts for a self-erecting wind energy plant and the reason for choosing a steel-steel hybrid tower. Then I give you an overview of the erecting and lifting concept. How does the erection of a tower works and which lifting and stabilization system do we use? Afterwards, I come to my main part, namely the transition piece for the self-erecting wind energy plant. During this chapter, I explain the sample plant we designed, the different requirements, the connections of the different tower parts, and the technical data of the design transition piece. At the end of my presentation, I give a short conclusion of the project. Let's begin with the reasons for the research project itself. There's the EU Climate Target Plan, which sets the goals to reach a share of at least 32% renewable energies in gross final energy consumption by 2030, and complete climate neutrality by 2050. These goals can only be reached by the expansion of wind energy in the EU. In Germany, we have unfortunately the situation that there are hardly any wind-rich areas left for the construction of new wind energy plants. That's why the energy output in low wind areas has to be increased. A way to do this is to build wind energy plants with larger hub heights and rotor diameters to use the stronger wind in the higher air layers. This is where the research of this Foster project comes in. The aim of this project is the development of a self-erecting onshore wind energy plant with hub heights greater than 120 meters. The goals in detail were the increasing of the power output through higher hub heights while simultaneously decreasing the main investment costs. The expected cost reduction results from the erection concept, which does not require any special cranes. A further goal named is the lowering of planning efforts through adequate dimensioning tools. Now I come to the tower concept for the self-erecting wind energy plant that is chosen in the project. For a self-erecting wind energy plant with large hub heights, a steel-steel hybrid tower is an especially suitable option. In the area of a rotor, a tubular tower is placed. It can be designed with a small diameter for the use of large rotors with slim blades. Below the rotor, a lattice tower is erected. In this way, transport problems of the large tubular segments in the base area of the tower are avoided. The lattice tower can be transported in smaller parts and erected directly on site. However, for the developed erection concept, a special transition piece must be added to the tower concept. Thus, on the one hand, these towers make it possible to avoid the transport problems of the large wind energy plants, and on the other hand, they provide a free space inside the lattice tower that can be used for the erection process, which I will describe in the following. Now I come to the erection concept. It's a further development of a lifting concept introduced in the RFCS short-time project. In phase 1, the tubular steel tower segments and the lattice tower sections are lifted and assembled alternately. As a result, the tubular tower stands subsequently within the lattice tower on a temporary foundation. In the next step, the transition piece with the lifting system is mounted on the lattice tower. Then the nacelle follows. Then the rotor blades can be mounted. Therefore, the rotor has to be turned top around. Due to the low assembly height of approximately 100 meters, a normal mobile crane is sufficient. There are no special cranes required. The strand lifting system lifts the tubular steel tower together with the wind turbine into its final position. Afterwards, the strand lifting system and the stabilization cylinders can be dismantled. In this concept, the lifting process is the most critical part. The lift will be realized with a 4-point strand lifting system, which will carry the vertical loads. However, the strand lifters cannot provide sufficient support for the tower against tilting and torsion. Therefore, an additional stabilization system is required. The stabilization is achieved by hydraulic cylinder levels, which take the bending moments via a pair of forces. Each cylinder level consists out of 11 pairs of cylinders. Each pair presses a bearing plate against the tower shell. The system can carry horizontal forces and torsional moments. For the lifting process, the stabilization system must be able to move upwards together with the tubular steel tower. So, the concept includes an intermediate guiding system, IGS, that enables the cylinder levels to move upwards. This is done step by step in single lifts. Furthermore, two additional cylinder levels at the upper and the lower end of a transition piece allows the IGS to be repositioned. All in all, four cylinder levels are necessary for this concept. Here, the concept of a single lift is shown schematically. In state 1, the cylinders of the IGS are activated and stabilize the tubular tower. The IGS is pulled upwards during the lift. At state 2, the IGS has reached the upper dead center, the endpoint of a single lift. In state 3, the outer cylinder levels are activated. Now they take over the stabilization of a tubular tower. The cylinders of the IGS are released. The IGS can now be lowered again. And finally, at state 4, the IGS has reached the bottom dead center. This is the starting point for the next single lift. So, the total duration of a complete lifting process depends mainly on the height of a single lift. An increase of a single lift can be achieved either by a higher transition piece or a shorter IGS with shorter lever arms. Therefore, the characteristics of a transition piece, the distance between the cylinder levels, and the lifting duration have to be optimized. Within the research project, a sample plan was designed to demonstrate the feasibility of this erection concept. The plant consists out of a 80-meter-high four-legged lattice tower and a 100-meter-high tubular steel tower. This leads to a total hub height of 180 meters. The following investigations and analyses for the transition piece were also carried out on the basis of this sample plant. The transition piece has to fulfill several requirements. Primarily, it must support the erection process. For this, it has to be able to accommodate both the strength lifting system and the stabilization system. In addition, a high internal space for a short lifting time is important. Clearly, it has to allow the safe operation of a wind energy plant. The connections and joints cannot only be designed for the erection process. They must also be designed for the operating conditions. Last but not least, the material and production cost must be kept as low as possible. To achieve these requirements, a fitting design for the transition piece has been developed. Therefore, the following basic design features of a transition piece were investigated on the sample plant. A strong focus was placed on the various connections, starting with the connections of a tubular steel tower to the transition piece. The connection is placed at the upper and lower end of the transition piece. At the beginning of the project, originally a ring flange connection was planned here, because they are already widely used for tubular steel towers. However, they have some important disadvantages, like a large space requirement or the fact that it's only possible to hang the tubular tower up from below. Instead, a category A connection is planned. The shear hole connection has no negative effects on the stabilization system. Therefore, it's an ideal solution for this application. To avoid transport problems, the transition piece must be divided into three segments. Each single segment complies with the maximum transport dimensions. For the connection of the different segments, ring flanges were again analyzed. Once again, they have been excluded because they would be very large, heavy, and restrict the stabilization system. Here too, a category A connection turned out to be particularly effective, so the amount of material used for this connection can be reduced. At the same time, the required internal space remains unaffected. Other alternatives, like the C1 wedge connection or the HISPIN connection, are also possible here. All other relevant connections within the transition piece are assumed to be fully welded. The shell thicknesses to be welded range from 18 to 80 mm. The last planned connection is the connection of a transition piece to the four-legged lattice tower. Therefore, the tower's legs are extended and bolted to the side of a transition piece's bottom segment. Due to the butterfly profiles of the lattice tower, simple angles can be used as connecting elements. These were assigned to be welded on the transition piece, so the butterfly profiles can be screwed on directly and without complicated constructions. At this specific geometry, the connection requires a fastening system that can be tightened from only one side. For example, tension control bolts or Hug Bobtail locked bolts. At the upper end of the connection angles, a circular ring stiffener prevents the shell from buckling. The transition piece was designed using the finite element method with Abacus software, so the required material thicknesses and geometries were defined. Here you can see the technical details of the developed transition piece. Due to the separation into three segments, the transport problems are successfully avoided. The height of each segment is under the critical mark of 4.30 meters. At the top of the transition piece, a temporary working platform allows the use of a strand lifting system. Inside, the clear height of almost 10 meters allows a high enough single lift with an 8 meter high IGS. The clear void, which is about 1 meter all around, is also large enough for the stabilization system. The shell thicknesses vary between 20 and 50 millimeters. Only S355 steel is used. The simple plant's transition piece has a total height of 10 meters and a weight of approximately 64 tons. Now I come to the conclusions of the project. As part of a Foster research project, Hightower, an adapted transition piece for a self-erecting steel-steel hybrid tower was developed. For this, the boundary conditions and requirements for a transition piece were defined based on a sample plant. Special attention was paid on the connection techniques, the mass and the space required for the lifting system inside and on top of the transition piece. By designing a transition piece for the sample plant, the feasibility of a transition piece for a self-erecting wind energy plant could be demonstrated, and design principles have been developed. However, a detailed design should be carried out in the next step for specific cases of use.
Last but not least, I want to thank the Foster, the AIF and the Federal Ministry of Economic Affairs and Energy for the financial support, as well as to the companies involved in the project for their professional support. Thanks for your interest and stay healthy.